In this video, we are going to talk about merge statement in Oracle or SQL in general. And we are going to look at two practical scenarios where it is used in real projects. So here we have a source table with three columns, ID, name, and salary. And for the sake of simplicity, let's use a similar table as our target. The source table has three records, and at this point, the target table is empty. For the first scenario, if the record does not exist in target table, we are going to insert it. So here, all three records should be inserted. And if the record exists in the target table, we are going to update it. So here, when we have a new row, it should get inserted. And the salary for Ron was updated in source, so it should get updated in our target as well. For the second scenario, we are going to add one more condition. If something gets deleted from the source that still exists in the target, it should get deleted from our target as well. Here the employee ID 1 was deleted from source, so it should get deleted from the target as well. So we are going to insert, update, and delete using just one statement. Let's switch to our SQL developer and we will see this in action. So I've already created two tables, source demo and target demo, and I've inserted three rows in my source table. Now we have to write a merge statement so that if these rows do not exist, they get inserted, and if they exist, they get updated. The syntax for merge is very straightforward. We will write merge into, they are SQL keywords, and then we will write the name of the table that we have to update. So we wrote merge into target underscore demo and we gave it an alias T. Then we wrote using is another keyword, and then we have to specify the table or query using which we will update our target table. Here we are updating it using the table source demo. So we wrote that and we gave it an alias S. Now we have to specify the join condition using which these two tables or dataset will be associated. Here we are joining them on ID column. So I've used that. The remaining condition is also very straightforward. We will write when matched then, that is, if the source record exists in target, then what should happen? For our scenario, we want the target to be updated. So we will write update set t.name is equals to s.name and t.salary is equals to s.salary. If the ID matches, these two columns will be updated. But if the ID does not exist in target, then we have to insert that row. For that, we will write when not matched, then insert this row from our source to our target table. Here, we will get all the values from our source dataset and they will get inserted in our target. So we wrote insert ID, name, salary, and we took the values from our source. So s.id, s.name, and s.salary. Now, when we execute this query, it will show us three rows merged, which means all three rows should now be present in our target table as well. Let's quickly verify that. Yes, we have the same data present in our target table as well. So the insert part is working fine in this statement. Now let's update one of the row and we are going to insert one more row. We have inserted a new row for Pam and we have updated the salary for Ron. We can verify that in our source table. And now, when we execute the same statement again, we will see that it shows four rows merged. Let's see the output of our target table. We have the new row and the salary for Ron has also been updated correctly. So our insert and update both are working fine. We can also add a where condition in our update. For example, We only want to update our records if the name is Pam. We can write t.name is equals to Pam in our merge statement. Now only the record where name is Pam will be updated. Even if we update anything else in the source, it will not get reflected in our target. Let's verify that. We will change the salary in our source table for both John and Pam. Let's make both of them as 60. We will quickly verify the data in our source table. And now, when we will run our merge statement again, we will notice that only one row got merged. If we query our target table, we will see that only the salary for Pam was updated. So even if we have matching data in our target, we can restrict the amount of data that we want to update. Actually, updates are cost intensive operations. They can take a lot of time to complete. We usually do this to restrict the updates only to the relevant changes. So till now, we have seen how can we insert records in our target if they are not present. How can we update them if they are present? And how can we restrict the number of matching records that we want to update? Now let's move to our other scenario where we will delete from our target in case if the record is not present in source. So we are going to delete ID1 from our source table. The row has been deleted. Now we need to make sure that it gets deleted from the target as well. For that, first we need to identify the IDs that have been deleted from our source. We will join the target table with our source using a full outer join, and we will use this new query as our source or reference dataset. Why are we using full outer join? We will see that in a moment. After executing this query, we can see that the record for Jane with the employee ID 1 exists in our target, but it does not exist in source. The values are null here. Also, I have changed the names of our source columns as source ID, source name, and source salary. In order to delete a record using merge statement in Oracle, we first have to update it. So we can either update the name and salary as null in our target table for employee ID 1, and then we can delete the records where name or salary is null. Now one may argue here that it may not work if we have a not null constraint on our target column. The update itself will fail. Or there is a possibility that for a record, source only sends the employee ID and the name and salary will be updated later. With our current approach, this record will also get deleted. So the wise option is to update the record with a value like -999 for salary, which is not feasible as source data, and we can use that for our deletion. Let's use NVL function to change this null value to -999. Now we will just replace the source table in our original merge query with this new dataset. Let's copy and paste it here. Also, since we have named our salary and name column from source table differently, we will have to update that as well. Let's update it here in our update statement and in our insert statement as well. Let's execute the merge statement again. After the execution, we will see that 4 rows are merged. And if we see the target table, we will notice that the salary for employee 1 has been changed to -999. Now all we need to do is delete records where salary equals to -999. We can update the existing merge statement. After update, we can add delete where salary equals to -999. But before we execute this, let's add one more row in our source, 5, Rick and 100. We will update Pam's salary to 200 and we will delete the row for John. If we run our source query again, we will see that we have two records, employee ID 1 and 2, that have been deleted from source. We have PAM, for which the salary is updated, and we have RIC, which is new in source and should be inserted in target. If we use inner or left or right join, we will see that some records will get dropped from our dataset and the target will not change correctly, which is why we have used full outer join. Now, if we have written our statement correctly, the row for RIC should be inserted, the row for PAM should be updated, and the rows for Jane and John with employee ID 1 and 2 should be deleted from our target because they have been deleted from our source as well. Let's run the merge statement and we will verify that our target and source table are in sync or not, and we get our expected result. How cool is that? We inserted, updated, and deleted all using a single statement. I hope this video was helpful. Guys, I'll drop the DDL and DML used in this section in the description for your reference. Please practice it, and in case if you still have any questions, please post them in the comment section and I'll be happy to help.